It's obviously disgusting to be thinking about eating other humans, but you would actually be surprised how often cannibalism actually happens in nature. This female spider, halfway through sex, will eat the male. Eating other people during sex is only good in some situations. Hit it, Missy! Go downtown and eat it like a vulture. Researchers out of the University of Toronto, shout out T-Dot!
The six!
Have found that the man will continue to transfer their sperm while the female consumes him. This is considered an evolutionary advantage because the male giving himself to the female means that she'll be able to consume more nutrients and therefore provide for her future babies. When the males are cannibalized, there's twice as many offspring than when they're not.
It was recently discovered that lance-headed rattlesnake mothers will actually eat their non-surviving babies. They do this in order to recover nutrients for the next time that they're reproducing. Allegedly, because the mothers eat their kids, it's actually the main reason that snakes don't celebrate Mother's Day.
Hippos are mostly herbivores, but researchers have found that in times of scarcity, they will scavenge for meat on other dead hippo carcasses. So the children's board game Hungry Hungry Hippos is literally just a giant metaphor for how hungry, desperate hippos will eat their own kind, and those little balls represent potentially them eating their best friends. So have fun, kids.
Cane toads actually prefer to eat their own species. When given the choice between eggs of their own species and eggs of another, they actually choose to eat their own. They've also been known to wiggle their toes at younglings, and when they come close, they eat them. So next time someone wiggles their toes at you, run.
Look at this cute little mustache tamaling.
Cannibal.
So one science researcher was just sitting there, you know, with their tilly hat and binocs, checking out these little tamarins when there was a mother, a daughter, and a son chilling on a branch. And then the mother, out of nowhere, grabbed the son, bit the head off, and then fed the carcass to the daughter. Researchers predicted that the mother did this because the daughter was pregnant, and therefore the brother's carcass and meat provided energy for the offspring.
Speaking of eating your siblings, sand tiger sharks do it all the time. The pregnant mother usually begins with 6 to 7 embryos, but once the first shark breaks out of the egg capsule, it eats a bunch of its siblings, which is why there's often usually one or two that actually survive.
Prairie dogs also like to eat their families as well. Scientists have documented prairie dogs raiding the dens and eating their close relatives. Scientists think that this cannibalism is done to decrease competition, so it really is a prairie dog eat prairie dog world out there, guys.
Sicilians are limbless, worm-like amphibians whose mothers let them peel their skin off and use it as a food source. Maybe when the apocalypse comes and we're all so desperate for food, we'll be having hors d'oeuvres made of our dead skin.
Some species also eat themselves.
Go eat yourself! Yo, hey Larry! Go eat yourself, bro!
Hey, yo Frank! Go eat yourself!
Eat me!
Yo Doink! Eat me!
Known as auto-cannibalism, the sea squirrel will actually eat its own brain as part of its life cycle. They begin their life as swimming larvae, but once they attach to a rock, they will not move ever again. Now that it's not moving, at this point it no longer needs its simple brain vessel, so it digests it for nutrients. It's also one of the prime examples why scientists think that the brain evolved for movement.
Sadly, stress and desperation has caused polar bears to start eating one another. Scientists report that with melting sea ice and fewer seals to feed on, this trend will only continue as climate change worsens.
Oh my gosh, Mitchell, stop eating me, please!
Sorry.
Okay, so we are thankfully as humans not desperate enough to eat ourselves, and that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm. But if you want to see all the food that we do eat, you can follow us on Instagram and Twitter and all the things. Otherwise, thanks for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you soon.